Just small spite. Okay. Yeah, that was a little small spite. All right, Daniel, I found this awesome Star Wars anime. All right, I do like my Star Wars. The TIE Fighter Remastered Star Wars short film. Okay.
Dude.
Sure, why not? You guys down for anime Star Wars?
A long time ago in a galaxy far away.
The Star TIE Fighter Wars. Fight up. Wars. Okay, of course. Tep Epitfo? Hopefully I said your name right. Thanks for the 19 months. Hey, Noble. It's AAA here. This is the new name. Perfect time to jump in with powder room memes, apparently. Yes, Tep. I guess I'm just going to call you Tepit or Tepitfo. Maybe that. All right, AAA, you know, everyone's got a new name. Jab, thanks for the 17 months. Booty slaps to you. Thank you so much. All right. It's pretty neat. I see the rebel fleets. And then the probe droid actually doing reconnaissance work for once instead of stupidly going out to die. There you go. Sending the message back to the Star Destroyer. Eyeball close up. I do like my eyeballs very close to my face. We found the rebel fleets, huh? And there we go. They're going to destroy the rebels. Look at them. They all have the same face. I mean, it's well done. Certainly very well done. Stormtroopers. All the budget for this went into the animation and no voice acting. I mean, you don't really need voice acting, I guess, if you just want to get the Star Wars feel. See the engines rev up. Man, this guy really likes mechanics and stuff like that, showing all the stuff take off. At least animating the TIE fighters moving is pretty easy to do. Just the sprite that goes across the screen. Ragnarok Karma, thanks for gifting a sub! Thank you so much, Booty Slaps you. Thank you, guys. This is extraordinarily well done, yes. Okay, that would have been a pain in the ass. Anime. Jesus fuck. Are you kidding me? They didn't instantly explode with one hit of a blaster? I thought that's usually what happens. Your boy's back. What's up, Jab? He's on the bits. Thank you.
Behind you, shake him off.
Oh, when you don't expect fire, one, two, two. I can't shake him. Oh, there was voice acting. All right.
Here's one of two idiots from Lime Dog.
Pretty impressive so far. Okay, the lip sync on that, not the best, but good enough.
Rebels coming into your range.
Shield activated!
Well, didn't they always have the shield activated?
The rebels are targeting our destroyer. Intercept immediately.
Okay. But aren't they inside the shield with them? Okay, that was quick. I'm surprised that they're staying so far away. Wouldn't the Star Destroyers absolutely destroy and bombard the Rebel ships because they're vastly superior in firepower? Why are they keeping their distance? But, you know, that's just me. Reminds me of the 80s and 90s Transformer shows a little bit, yeah. how to donate says Ragnarok, there's a link below. You can donate with Twitch Bits, which is integrated with the Twitch system, or you can use the donate button below the stream. There's also a way to watch ads, apparently.
And he's got medication for you.
Thank you, Jeff. All right. What females in the Empire? Well, to be fair, I guess this is after the Clone Wars.
We're almost ready to turn our attention to their pathetic transport ship.
Are you on PC or... Oh, yeah, that's right. That does matter, I guess, in how you don't. I wouldn't know. Oh. Yeah, I don't know how the phone works, necessarily. I remember a distinct lack of good space battles.
Take out
that last pathetic scene of like the 1,000 Star Destroyers with planet weapon destroyed, that was the most pathetic battle I've ever seen. It was so pathetic. Fantasy Star Wars ships and stuff like that. You can have armadas, big cruisers, battles, blasters, all these set up here. And then you just have the most pathetic thing in the world. It was such a letdown. It was very difficult to figure out how to fly up. I know, right? Guys, how do we leave the planetary orbit? The opposite direction of gravity? Shit! Admiral, there seems to be horses on our wing. What do we do? We can just tilt the ship sideways. What? You mean we could just tilt the ship sideways and they would fall off? Yes, sir. They would fall off. That's impossible. We can't even navigate up and you expect us to flip the ship over? Like, oh, so, I'm sorry, sir. Apologize to your superior officer this instant. Like, okay. Yeah, it's like, how do we go into space? We can't do it without this one planetary beacon. We can't. We have a singular beacon that's responsible for navigating these thousands of planet-destroying star cruisers. One singular unshielded beacon. Are you fucking... I just can't fucking... Anyway, yeah, it makes sense. It totally makes sense. Hello, Noble. How do you like the popcorn?